You brothers and sisters in Christ, on this solemnity, it's a great thing to learn something about the number 40. 40. Especially it's related to this solemnity of the ascension of the Lord. So most of the countries throughout the world, Catholics celebrate the solemnity ascension, the ascension of the Lord last Thursday. Tradition of Ascension Thursday developed not because we know historically that Jesus ascended into heaven on the third day, but rather that it counts 40 days since the resurrection, the great feast of Easter. Biblical significance of 40 is huge. We recall the 40 days and 40 nights of the flood. 40 days of Moses was with Yahweh on Mount Sinai before the giving the covenant. 40 years of the Israelites wander in the desert. And 40 days Jesus fasted in the wilderness to name a few. Then from the ascension, we count the next 9 days, a novena, a preparation for the Pentecost, thus linking the passion, death, and resurrection, ascension, and sending the Holy Spirit into one saving mystery and mission. We celebrate Jesus' work of redemption, our salvation, accomplished and then handed on to the church, to each and every one of us. What Jesus did, we are invited to participate in and proclaim until he returns at the end of time. Let me repeat again, what Jesus did, we are invited to participate in and proclaim until he returns to the end of time. At this point of human history, we stand in a long line of believers whose lives have been shaped and fashioned by Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Jesus said, "You will receive the power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." As Jesus spoke these words to his disciples the day he ascended to the Father, he speaks to them on this ascension. Jesus said to his disciples, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved." Jesus speaks the same word to each and every one of us today, at this very moment, on this solemnity of the ascension of the Lord, 2022. Go out and speak to the folks one-on-one, and you will receive the power of the Holy Spirit. Proclaim the gospel to every creature. Baptize in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. That is our mission, brothers and sisters. Just as Jesus Christ encountered and called and formed his disciples and sent them out on his behalf, so too does Jesus encounter us in the sacramental life of the church and send us out as witnesses. We come here for Mass, receive Jesus, and then a blessing. After the dismissal of Mass, we're sending out to do that mission, to proclaim the good news, to baptize all nations. And we know that this is not an easy task. But we have a prayer of St. Peter and St. Paul to confirm the Ephesians to assist us as well. St. Paul says, "May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation resulting in knowledge of Him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to His call. What are the riches of glory in His inheritance among the holy ones? And what is the surpassing greatness of His power for us who believe?" says St. Paul. So whatever we do, in deed or in words, is the works of the Holy Spirit within us. Brothers and sisters in Christ, this is not some makeup story or some myth, some fly-by-night scam. It is the most meaningful expression of love, communion, that has ever been or ever will be. It is a mystery of God's total, unconditional, absolute love for us in the gift of Jesus Christ, who came to reconcile us to the Father after we had turned our backs on the gift of the Father's love to sin. As we heard the last week from the first letter of John, John said, "Love consists in this, not that we have loved God, but that God first loved us and sent His Son as expiation for our sins." God's always the initial person who reached out to us. God first loved us and continues to love us in and through the church. St. Paul once again says, "God put all things beneath Christ's feet and gave Him as head over all things in the church, which is His body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way." We learn and we know that Christ is the head of the church. We are His body, the member of Christ's family. So my brothers and sisters, this is why we are here today. It is what gives meaning and purpose to our lives. It is what animates us and sends us out. It is what we celebrate each time we gather here for the Mass, the Holy Eucharist. For me, I desire nothing more than to share with as many as I can the love of the Father in Jesus Christ and the power of the good news that can and does change lives. You and I get to witness to this. We get to be bearers of good news in the world, so filled with bad news, depression news, and hateful news. So I would like to include this reflection by quoting Pope Francis. The Pope said, "The solemnity of the Ascension of the Lord lifts our gaze upwards beyond earthly things. At the same time, it reminds us of the mission of the Lord has entrusted to us here on earth. May the Holy Spirit guide us. In good battle we must wage. Happy the solemnity of Ascension of the Lord to you all. Thank you.
Blessings to you all on this feast of the Ascension. Before I offer a few words of reflection, just want to thank you all for your prayers for my health. I was not here last weekend because, well, I tested positive for COVID and was in quarantine. God's healing has helped me test negative, and I'm out of quarantine, and it's a joy to be back celebrating with you. So, let us continue to pray for an end to this pandemic, as well as for all the caregivers who give so much at home and in the hospitals. We are deeply grateful for their care. Throughout the Easter season, we have been celebrating and remembering the victory of Jesus over sin and death in and through his resurrection from the dead. Or as St. Paul would write, death no longer has power over him. 40 days after his resurrection, Jesus ascended into heaven, as we heard in our readings. This will set into motion the coming of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, as Jesus promised, and as we will celebrate next Sunday. All throughout this past week, at daily Mass, we heard from John chapter 16, where Jesus repeatedly speaks of the Advocate, the one who would come after him to bring to completion all that the Father had given to him. Therefore, it was necessary for him to ascend, as we heard in our responsorial psalm, to his throne in heaven, to sit at the Father's right hand. We began our Lenten journey of 40 days with Jesus' 40 days of fasting, prayer, and contending with the devil in the desert, reminiscent of the 40 years that the Israelites spent wandering around in the desert. This cosmic battle with Satan comes to a climax in the suffering and death of Jesus on the cross, he who is our true high priest. Jesus is the true sacrifice, the sacrificial lamb, who gives himself to reconcile all of humanity to the Heavenly Father, so that divine life might be available to all through him. This is what St. Paul wrote to the Ephesians in our second reading. May the eyes of your heart be enlightened, so that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power to all who believe. Jesus himself brings to completion his mission on earth in preparation of sending the Holy Spirit, the Advocate, to establish the church and to continue his mission here on earth and to invite us to partake in his very mission. You are witnesses of these things, and behold, I am sending the promise of my Father upon you, as he said. And in our first reading, we also heard, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, even to the ends of the earth. My sisters and brothers, we are to be witnesses to Jesus Christ in a world, a culture, and in a time of our national history that in so many ways rejects and ignores Jesus. Be it ignoring the unrelenting teaching of the church around the sanctity of human life, be it the horror that we've experienced this past week in yet another mass shooting in a school, be it the ineffective immigration policy that we presently have, be it the challenge of the continued degradation of the environment, or the amassing of more and more wealth among fewer and fewer people in the world. In light of all these challenges, our faith in Jesus Christ can be shaken, and we can feel at times that prayer, that faith, is ineffectual and meaningless. It is at moments such as these that we need Jesus more than ever, and to lean into sacred scripture and the teaching of the church. Rather than walking away in doubt and confusion, we need to cry out for the gift of the Holy Spirit to be renewed in our hearts and minds and souls, so that we can bear fearless witness to Jesus Christ in and through his church. We are not alone. As Archbishop Aitchen shared in a short video reflection that we shared with you in our Saturday SMP Connect email, we personally and as a nation need to take stock of who we are and what kind of a people and nation we want to be. On this Feast of the Ascension, I invite you, I invite all of us, to ask ourselves, what kind of witness am I to the risen Christ? What kind of a witness am I here in Thurston County? How am I being called to witness in the power of the Holy Spirit to Jesus Christ and to his loving Father? Men, fathers, how do you do this as the spiritual head of your household? How are you to witness to your spouse and to your children? How are you to protect them from the wickedness and snares of the devil as we pray to St. Michael at the end of every Mass? Mothers, women, how can you daily nurture the faith of your spouse or your children in your home, your domestic church? How can you inculcate prayer, reading of Scripture, and an atmosphere of saint-making in your homes? And what about me? How will I witness? As your pastor and your spiritual father, together with our liturgy team, I will lead you to Jesus through the adoration of the Blessed Sacrament during the month of June, after every Mass. I will witness to Jesus' perpetual presence in our midst through 24/7 adoration and invite you to participate by making a commitment to perpetual adoration for this coming year. Today, we mourn and grieve with the families and communities of Uvalde, Texas, with the suffering people of Ukraine, with the starving people in East Africa suffering with more than 4 years of continual drought. We mourn and grieve with refugees throughout the world fleeing terror and oppression. And we grieve with so many of our sisters and brothers who find themselves alone and broken, disheartened and despairing. Let us, each of us, all of us together, like those first disciples, witness to the hope that surpasses all understanding in Christ Jesus. Let us pray and support one another through our actions to be true missionary disciples of our risen and ascended Lord, Jesus Christ.